Okay, so we are observing there are these types about the adaptation of bryophytes in our study, this credit. So as there are the in some habitats, particularly while we are going to see this type. So here the epiphytes and the epiphyllus or epiphylls are there. So these habitats generally seen in the tropics, where the high rainfall or the high temperature is there, and therefore there is the greatest diversity is there. Already we are knowing in bryophyta diversity means the thalloid members are there, leafy members are there, mosses are there, and they are all having the different types. So generally all mosses, these are also having the different conditions, generally indicators of the water availability. So xerophytes, hydrophytes are there, then semophytes are there, etc. There are the some world authorities, according to Perry in 1978, so they have given the special collecting facts and the preservation techniques for these specimens are there. Particularly the bryophytes found on the bark of the tree, so they are generally protected, and as due to the wood contents are there, so they are not affected by different other diseases are there. In relation to epiphytic bryophytes, their growth is generally showing the different directional vertical, or the bark is there. So as per the factors affecting, already we are knowing sunlight is there, or your this part about the temperature is there, then wind flow is there, right? So from the different sites are there, suppose their bark conditions are the rough, smooth, or the fissured, like the certain caves are there, small caves or flaking types, they are wrinkled types. So and there is having the directions are there, north, south, east, and the west are there. So as per this their adaptation is generally related. Secondly, in relation to while considering the canopy is there, so we have to go for the these bryophytic species. They are in the greatest challenge. These are typically out of the reach, and therefore the researchers have been successfully using a single rope to do the tree climbing is there. So there are the different skills they have generally obtained generally for the collection of the these epiphytic bryophytic species, and there is having the certain study. So then what is the meaning of the canopy is there? So you are knowing the good example, as suppose you are standing at the hilltop of the any place, suppose Mahabaleshwar is there, and we are observing the greenery at the lower side. So this greenery is nothing but it shows a one limit of the growth of the these larger trees are there, and commonly it is called as the canopy. So this type of the forest plants commonly seen in the equatorial region, where the virgin forest are there. Virgin, that is the untouched type of the forest are there, and they shows the certain canopy condition. According to Gradstein in 2003, so they have studied the different branches of this canopy conditions, and they have found that the colonization of the these bryophytic species are there. As we are knowing, the different Diffie-Junger manuals commonly found in the epiphytic and the epiphyllous conditions are there. As you can remember these different factors, so as per the large trees, heavy rainfall, heavy temperature, heavy wind flow is there. So in certain conditions, these bryophytic species are commonly seen or adapted. then epiphyllous conditions are also the same, because I know the smaller bamboo leaves are there, or there are the larger Tectona grandis like leaves are there, so they show the growth at the certain this tropical region. So commonly here the humidity is the more, and therefore their morphology, their growth, it is the different, and it shows the up to the certain changes at the species level is there, right? Then secondly, there should be having the different types of the conditions are there. We are knowing the we have to use the dissecting microscope for the observation in detail. So, and while studying these some members like Leguminosae, so they are generally showing the specific type of the flat nature of the dorsiventral characteristic. It is generally seen upper dorsal surface and the lower surface. So here the other conditions like the we are knowing cohabitants are there with bryophyte, fungal association or the BGA association, cyanobacteria, they are also associated with, and therefore the humid climate is this necessary or used in association by the this bryophytic species. So this is also an adaptive character. Basically, as there are the some aquatic samples studied by the different authorities are there. So in the dry condition, generally they are generally found along with the bacteria, fungi or algal members are there. And secondly, when we are removing water from their habitat, so generally still they are attached to the this species. So this is also a very interesting condition observed. Then there are the certain members are there, so excess water or the less water, it also shows the growth, and different branches are there. So delicate species, like here you observe the example like Fontanellis, moss is there. So this moss also found on the same branches are there, so it is given by this. Then while considering adaptation, the physiological ecology, it is also one part. So its magnitude, it is smaller than that of the other vascular plants are there, angiosperm or gymnosperm. But there are the differences, not differences in the structural organization and the physiology. So as we are knowing, the different insects or vertebrates are there. So they are also generally showing there is no effect on this one. Then surface area, about the volume covered, then certain limiting factors like the other disturbance of the vertebrates or the certain tree species are there on the tree species. So generally they also tolerate the certain disturbances. So therefore this is also one kind of the adaptation. Conditions of the certain vascular plants are there. So while we are considering these vascular plants, we are knowing there is having the certain in the leaves. So laminar, cuticle or stomata, epidermal regions are there. So these structures, they also having a specifically developed in the some bryophytic species are there. Already we are knowing order Markensians or these other types are there. So they shows the air pores and the, this condition. In physiological condition shown by the different authorities as long term, then or Proctor in 1980 or 81 period up to 1990. So there are the adaptive strategies has been observed in the some bryophytes. Suppose mineral nutrition and pollution responses, they are given by the Brown and the Betts up to the 1992. The responses of the major environmental factors, they are also studied by the Russell in 1990. So we have to see about the temperature relation on photosynthesis or the other parts are there. Secondly, eco-physiological characteristics. They are also studied in relation to the bryophytes. Then we are knowing the water relations are there. So already in our country, monsoon period is the main, but all over the world there are the two seasons, winter and the summer. But the certain regions, famous like California or the other mountainous part or the African regions are there. So throughout the year, the climate is in certain area, humid climate is there. So they showing the ectohydric, then free liquid water moving capillaries are there. In the some good example about the Dawsonia and the Polytrichum species, then members of the family Niaceae. Miam is the one genus also. From this only one typical genera family is separated. Then they having the water conducting hydroids and the substantial proportion of the water conduction in the internal development are there. So they functions like the xylem tissue. Then endohydric mosses, they having the conduction, and externally the capillaries are there. So sheathing lip base or the presence of rhizoid tomentum. Tomentum is, that is the enlarged part at the basal portion of this rhizoid. It is called as tomentum. So generally water loss or these other factors are generally controlled, and it is called as the poikilohydric. So this condition is there. Generally in vascular tissues we are knowing basically other advanced character, but here the scales are present. Already we are knowing in Merkantials the scales are present. So these scales generally they help particularly for the give additional support and the for the regeneration, that is they develop in the next season. Then secondly, acrocarpus certain mosses. Acrocarpus means where the archegonia develop at the top, so they are called as acrocarpus. Secondly, there are the Merkantials liverworts are there. So these liverworts, they shows external and internal conduction is also there. Already we are knowing Anthridio 4, Archegonia 4 in order Merkantials, right? In some members are there. Secondly, as per our study, in adaptation, there is having the, so water conduction is the important character. Capillary spaces are there. Secondly, sheathing lip base, it is the most important part. Good examples, Phalaenotis and the Thuidium. Remember the genera, Phalaenotis and the Thuidium is there. So here, they shows the paraphylia, that is the rhizoids, like capillary. And secondly, other examples like the Encalyptra, then Syn trichea and the Anomodon, they also shows the shoots along with the this rhizoidal paraphylia is there. So remember these some examples. In certain bryophytes there are the terms, they are illustrated as HO. That is the, as it shows the character, as basically you are observing this diagram. So how the external capillary actions, they are studied in Porella, it is the Lippi Junger manual. And this diagram, as you are observing on left hand vertical water potential and the relative cell volume, so how the cells are enlarged. So they shows the ascending and the descending. So water potential in the second graph, and in the first graph they shows like. So here this diagram illustrate the our part is there. Here the basically it shows the about the components of osmotic potential and the water potential, then turgor pressure with reference to the relative cells are there. So in certain liverworts, Porella, Platyphylla, it shows the thermocouple or psychrometer measurements are there, and these are to be studied. So horizontal dotted lines indicate the turgor loss point, and the rectangular hyperbola it is fitted to the data points below this. So therefore just you observe it and do the your understanding, right? So please see this one, relative cell volume and the water potential. Then there are the certain other types are there about the cell wall is there. So cell walls generally they shows the division between apoplast water in the cell walls. Then simple water conditions, capillary water conditions, these are studied by different authorities like Dix and Proctor in 1979 and other scientists. So as per their observation, full turgor water content is generally seen, generally having the which is studied for the physiological comparable character to that of vascular plants. RWC value is based on the saturated water content. So what is meaning of saturated? Saturated is nothing but where the dissolution point is controlled. So it is we are calling as the saturated. So with reference to this, actual estimate of this water turgor is generally calculated. Then secondly, this condition, it is generally studied for the adaptive view or the capillary condition in the bryophytic species. It is compared in terms of true RWC, that is the cell wall content relative to the cell water, right? Relative water cell content. So therefore photosynthesis in bryophytes and the differing the adaptive types with that of vascular plants, it is studied. So you see this photograph in the different species. Tortula is there, C. conium or the Oleracea in three species. So it is generally showing the photosynthesis related to photosynthesis. So it shows the net photosynthesis to water deficit in the two contrasting bryophytes from the gas exchange measurement, and the data further recalculated by Tuba in 1996. So 165% dry mass is estimated, and therefore this turgor pressure she observed in the Conocephalum conicum, and it is also studied in the Spinacea measurement of the spinach, or compared with the spinach is there. So like this the study is done. Nextly, there are the certain important physiological adaptive characters are there. So here the water content is generally studied as in relation to water storage. The other conditions like as capillary water conditions, they are studied. Then some good examples in the African forest, mosses like the Pilotrichella ampulacea. So it shows the PV curve which turn out to have a total water content corresponding to the RWC, as we have seen the above graph is there, right? So it shows the overlapping conditions to the other mosses or compared to the vascular plants are there. The effect of external storage, it shows the different functions are there. So as from the different bryophytic point of view, any habitat is the wet during and following the rain and dry at the other times, and therefore the primary differences in are there. So this is our one of the lecture in relation to the adaptations in the bryophyte. In the next lecture we will also again observe in the some other points to the this point. Okay, thanks to all.